figured out. You know why we didn't call the police when we were kids? Those damn rotary phones. By the time you dial a 9 on 911, the parents have already found you.
Good
it's
point.
Like, yeah, there you are! You couldn't call them in time, and your dad, my dad, would just pick up the phone and go, yeah, send an ambulance, too. I'm really going to hurt
you know,
this
I was
kid.
I was at Wendy's. It was like a month ago, I guess. Maybe 5 weeks ago. It was a little more than a month ago. The thing. The fast food place.
Okay.
But anyway, I was because I was taking someone there, and there was a mom and a kid that were arguing. And the kid, the mom was saying, you just wait till we get home. And the kid actually made the threat. He said, if you hit me, I'm going to call the police on you.
Yep.
And the mom's response was priceless. She was like, good, they'll take you away. I'll never have to deal with you again. And the kid shut up. And I was like,
go
in
mom.
Your face. Yeah, I was like, go mom.
We need more of that. Which leads into what everybody wants to hear, another ass-beating story.
Okay.
I remembered a new one. When I was growing up, my parents, until I was 16, wouldn't let me leave the yard.
Mm-hmm.
That was like, you know, this is where you... And the thing I didn't know is that rule applied if we were on the road. So we went to some uncle's house in Georgia, and they had a bicycle. And I took off on it, you know, not knowing that I wasn't allowed to leave the area around the house.
Uh-huh.
So I rode like a mile out, and I turned around, and I rode like a mile back. But when I get halfway to the house, it's foggy and stuff. And suddenly I see Grandma step out of the fog.
Okay.
Well, that's creepy.
Walking towards me, slapping the belt against her thigh. Now, I gunned the bike. I just rode right past her. She got one good lick on me, and I rode back to the house. I made it to the house like 5 minutes before she got there.
Yep.
And hide in the bathroom.
I ran in. I'm like, okay, she's going to kill me. Where can I hide? My Uncle Ed's like, behind the closet. So I hide in the closet, and then I hear the door open. She kicks the screen door open. Where is that son of a bitch? Uncle Ed says, he's in the closet. As she's walking to the closet on the hardwood floor, he says, nope. Now, Doris, no, we can't have any of that. Let me get a beer. Okay, go ahead. And as soon as he got a beer, they beat my ass. They didn't have cable, so that was the entertainment.
Wow.
We need more of that.
Yeah.
Hey, I sent Yappy a different link. I don't know if we want to show it or not. Yappy can figure it out if we want to or not.
What is it?
It is a very, very unexpected thing.
Why does your phone go off like a clown horn?
That was his phone?
Yeah, that's his phone going beep,
beep,
beep.
I thought it was the music.
No, that's his phone.
But I found a video through a friend.
Okay.
It's very unexpected. It's very Star Trek oriented.
All right.
And very, very...
Oh, it wasn't converted and downloaded, so it can't do anything with it yet.
Oh, like I said, I just sent the YouTube link, so...
Yeah, he has to download them.
Yeah, like I said, we can watch it whenever he can do that.
It'll take a few moments.
We should do another ass-beating story.
Well, I don't have another one yet, but I do have this week's nutshot.
Ooh.
Hang on.
KP, you got any?
Any butt beating
stories? What,
nutshots? No, any ass beating stories.
Ass beating stories.
You met his mother, right?
I didn't get
in. Oh, she's a sweetie.
Mom never laid a hand on him.
I never really got in trouble when I was a kid.
Oh, I got in trouble.
Oh, God. I could tell one.
Hourly.
Do you have an ass beating story, Rocky?
My dad would take me by the hair, drag me upstairs, feet just dragging behind him like he's pulling a towel.
Right.
And in that room, it got ugly.
I don't doubt it.
Screaming, crying, pain. But I deserved it.
I don't doubt it. What's up, Rocky?
Bad dog.
He's going to sing something else, isn't he?
He is.
Oh, okay.
Kids, we're country!
If I didn't eat my onions,
bimbo,
I would get beat up.
Where you gonna go, we old bimbo, bimbo? What you gonna do, we old bimbo, bimbo? Does your mommy know that you're going down the road to see a little girly old? Bimbo is a little boy who's got a million friends, and every time he passes by, they all invite him in. He'll clap his hands, sing and dance, and talk his baby talk. With a hole in his pants and his knees sticking out, he's just big enough to walk. Bimbo, bimbo, where you gonna go, we oh? Bimbo, bimbo, what you gonna do, we oh? Bimbo, bimbo, does your mommy know that you're going down the road to see a little girly oh? Big boo. blue eyes that light up like a star. And the way to light them up is to buy him candy bars. Cracker Jack and bubble gum will start his day off right. All the girlies follow him just to beg him for a bite. Bimbo, bimbo, candy on your facey, oh. Bimbo, bimbo, chewing on your gummy, oh. Bimbo, bimbo, when you gonna grow? Everybody loves you, little baby bimbo. Him sitting still, he's just the roving kind. Although he's just a little boy, he's got a grown-up mind. He's always got a shaggy dog a pulling at his clothes, and everybody calls to him as down the street he goes. Bimbo, bimbo, where you gonna go? Oh, bimbo, bimbo, what you gonna do? Oh, bimbo, bimbo, does your mommy know you're going down the road to see a little girlie, oh. Bimbo, 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 bimbo.
Stop talking about the bimbos.
I gotta know. Yappy, every few weeks you get into like a hardcore old country mood. Is that when you break out the sour mash or what?
I want to know because I love country music.
Yeah, but he goes back a few years.
I like the older stuff, too.
That's like the 40s and 50s. I know who Jim Reeves is.
I didn't know
that. I had that on a little 78 that was, like, yellow.
I was going to say.
Why was it yellow?
Because it was a kid's song.
Yeah.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. Like, those little, like, they're like 45s, only 78s with the yellow label.
Yeah. Yep. They were made of that hard-ass plastic.
Okay, that's creepy.
Aye, Shrek.
That's Shrek?
Yeah, that's Shrek.
You sure that's Shrek?
Yes,
yes.
For sure.
That looks like a woman.
Is that the kind of woman you dream of?
No. Like a wicked witch woman.
We also want to say hi. We have another new viewer in channel. His name is...
We got to start all over again.
No.
We got to start all over again.
Okay. I'll break out the boat paddle.
We thought you had it down as what a woman was, and now you think Shrek is a woman. We got to start from scratch.
It's Girl Shrek.
It's not even Girl Shrek. It's just ugly regular Shrek.
All right. Well, anyway, Rocky D.A., we're sorry. We didn't mean to miss you. Welcome to the show.
Yeah, we apologize. We're a lot of new people on the show tonight. But again, welcome if we did miss you. We love you anyways.
So we had some sad news come out this weekend.
Oh.
We found out about sad things.
Ronnie James Dio died.
We knew that. Oh,
we already knew
again.
That.
Yeah. Well, this is Megaplex sad news.
Megaplex died too?
Oh, no. I heard about this.
We found out that one of the events that we wanted to do with Megaplex, we've done it for a while.
The Dutch Oven Contest.
No. It is the Fun Spot outing. The Fun Spot outing that is open to fursuiters so they can go go-karting is no longer possible.
Oh!
So
What happened?
Well,
what's the dirt? What's the drama?
So there's no drama.
There is.
Here's the deal. So at the Elliott events today, they also do the same thing.
There's the drama.
No. Well, what happened was a few months ago, there was another person. Now, this was not a person in costume. She was wearing a scarf.
Stupid scarf.
Well, she was wearing a scarf, and the scarf got caught in one of the go-kart engines and almost, like, choked her to death, literally. It injured her. So their insurance company will no longer allow anyone to wear anything that dangles or has, like, a scarf or any trailing fabric. So that includes tails and anything that will block vision, which includes the costume heads.
No capes.
Are you sure it was not a suitor?
No, they said it was a person. It was it was a lady wearing a scarf. And they specifically said a scarf. So they said their insurance company no longer allows anything that has draping or trailing fabric or anything that obscures the vision. So they
good logic, actually.
Yeah. So now the
and it's actually not just this place. It's happening
a lot of places. But the fursuit outing to Fun Spot is no longer possible. So we apologize for that. It is very sad news.
Now,
it's not anything we control.
Can you still do a regular outing just without tails?
Yes, you can do regular outings, but you can't wear anything like
so
a tail.
So you should still do it. Just out in suit.
You can do the bumper cars.
You can do the bumper cars.
For
now. I did that
until someone dies.
Well,
and
they don't have
the skydiving thing.
Yeah, they don't have like the trailing engine. That's what it was. It got caught in the engine behind the car.
You did bumper cars in suit?
I did bumper cars in suit, yeah.
Okay, because when I officially asked them, they said none of the rides.
When I went around, the ladies just said, yeah, no problem.
The lady.
That was probably that one ride operator that wasn't queued in yet.
Just started working yesterday.
Well, all the other guys were like very blunt about it and to a point even rude and.